Are you vaccinated?
Yeah, I am, actually.
I am, yes. Yeah.
How many more would you take?
I'd take whatever was recommended.
Shit, man, fuck all that vaccine shit.
Did you take it?
Yes.
Yeah, I got 2 shots, definitely.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm boosted up.
My fucking basketball coach said, like, if I get vaccinated, I'll have another hand or something. I was like, what the fuck, man? Like,
yeah, I got it, too.
I got it once. I got, like, the first dose.
Yeah, but I could tell you a secret about the government that nobody knows.
I took the freaking, what's it called, booster, right?
I would say 3 is enough.
Like, you took 4, though.
I mean, school required it, so I was like, yeah, fuck it, why not?
And I literally passed out from it.
Why did you put the vaccine up to a rock, paper, scissors shoot?
So me and my mom were like, okay, like, one of us has to get vaccinated first. And we was like, okay, so let's rock, paper, scissors. And I was like, that's easy, I'm gonna win. I fucking lost. I got both of them. And then she was like, yeah, I'm not getting it. She got a fake vaccine card.
How many more would you take?
I'll take another if I need another.
You need another based on them telling you or because of your health?
Based on how the virus changes, and you know, if the evidence shows that we need more boosting, then I'm up for boosting.
Depending on how many I gotta take, I just don't want to get sick out here, and I mean, catch some disease that I know I ain't gonna be able to, you know, cure it.
One more.
What if they said 2 more?
I'd gauge if I'm going anywhere or traveling anywhere with that, like, that type of requirement.
Like, up to 3, I was like, it was fine. Like, maybe, like, up to 3, I was like, COVID thing, but then up to 4 is too much. It feels like a season pass, like, Call of Duty shit.
So my parents are doctors, and my sister is a doctor, and, like, her husband is a doctor, and from the research that they've done, it feels like 3 are enough.
Feels like it?
I mean, from what they've told me, and I trust them.
The doctors don't care about you. They genuinely see you as a weight to bill. Like, literally, I just started this job. I don't want to get in trouble.
It's just your opinion.
Not like where I work, but generally speaking, they don't, like, there's this one patient, the woman looks at the chart, she goes, oh, they're schizophrenic, I'm not looking at them. She's like, I don't want to deal with schizophrenic people, they're too crazy for me. And you're a medical assistant, what are you talking about?
I've always worked in the intensive care unit, and you see how much people need the care, and they're unable, the stress that the nurses are under is tremendous. All of the workers in the hospital.
So knowing all this, why are you so quick to get all the vaccines and stay safe, knowing that they monetize health so much?
Well, we know the history of vaccines. We know the fact that they've made a huge difference in terms of saving people's lives around the world. We think this country should have turned over the vaccines to other countries that needed them rather than using them to make a profit.
What did they choose to do?
What?
Do they choose to make a profit or give it to the other countries?
Oh, this country? Come on.
Every single day, it's high A1C, prescribe them this, the same medications. And I'm just like, and some people be like on 20 medications and they don't even know how to pronounce it half the time. Like, and I feel so bad for the patients because they genuinely want to get better, but I don't feel like the medications that they're giving them is like not doing anything. I feel like the most important thing is the diet, but they're not telling them.
Are you vaccinated?
No.
Why not? You're the first person all day that said that.
Where? Shit.
Why'd you get it in the first place? Was it because you wanted to or because you had to?
I wanted to because, like, COVID-19 was that serious at that time during 2020. So I kind of wanted to get a vaccine shot just to keep myself safe at least. But then up to the thinking when it's like third shot, I was like, is this really necessary to get a third one?
I'm supposed to get it twice, but I only got one dose.
Was it a health decision or a financial decision?
It was a financial. It was definitely like so I could be in position to get some bread.
I took it to protect my health.
Well, I bought into this whole fear that it can hurt you, hurt other people. And I still don't know if this was the right decision or not, but I am. It is what it is.
So you think you did it out of fear, not really about health?
I would say so. I would fear. Yeah, that was the moving force for me.
I sold my soul.
Sold your soul?
Shit, that's what it felt like pretty much. Yeah. Just because I'm only doing it just so I could get gigs and shit.
So it was a financial decision, it wasn't a health decision.
100%. Because I'm in really good shape, so I kind of took, like, oh, my immune system is good, I think I'll be all right. You know what I mean? So.
Do you regret taking it?
No, I don't regret it. I tend not to regret because that's not a good feeling that I'll actually dwell with.
If I had to go back, if I knew it was going to be like this, I wouldn't have done it, for sure.
What if you had to travel, you had to get another booster shot? A lot of countries, they're making the citizens take more booster shots just to get in the plane. Would you do it?
What? Are you serious?
Yeah, they're going to keep adding updates.
Why? I thought that was like 2 was enough. Like,
nah, they're going to keep adding updates.
I can't do no more. I feel like my body's just like, we can't do it.
Now, I was sick for like 2 days after that shit, after each one. It's not worth all that shit.
My arm was like dead. I couldn't use, I had to call out of work for 2 days because my arm was not working.
Probably, I'm not gonna lie.
You gonna risk traveling for a blood clot?
I mean, if the bag is over in another country, then fuck it.
So you'll sell your soul for a bag?
Yeah.
Why you got the mask on?
It's for like protection, like for my face. I'm like, I don't like people like looking at me. You feel me? Like,
you're not really wearing it right now.
Not right now. Like, I usually wear it like after I smoke. Like, that's when I really be feeling like paranoid type shit.
You trust the government?
Definitely not. Definitely not. I mean, I'm from Haiti, so, you know, you already knew about the government already. It's the same.
Like, especially, like, with COVID and shit, I feel like that was, like, a way for them to, like, hide, like, whatever they had going on, like, with them. Like, if that makes sense. Like, I feel like... Yo, I smoked this morning, bro. I don't really know what I'm trying to say right now.
No, there's, like, a general sense in the discourse at the moment of just causing doubt without, you know, there's the absence of evidence is a reason to doubt. And I think that can be dangerous to the fabric of society. That's not to say that there's not problems with big corporations and, you know, too powerful governments, but the just doubt for the sake of doubt, it's like a cancer.
Just basically they scam, you know, it's a scam, you know. A lot
of people trust the government.
Yeah, I think they're bullshitting though, you know. I think they're bullshitting. Just, you know, in the back of your head, it's something wrong.
Do you trust the government?
I'm not from here, but yeah, I'm from Vietnam, international.
Do you trust the U.S. government?
U.S. government. At least it's better than my country's government, so yeah.
We bombed the shit out of you.
You bombed the shit out of me. I mean, it's in the past, so yeah, whatever. But I don't fuck with history either, so. Nah.
It's not that long ago. You're great. Like, that shit happened to your parents.
Life, yeah. I mean, fuck them, but whatever.
I don't know they're bullshitting, but they're willfully ignorant. They like to believe that the government cares about them.
Yeah, but you know in the back of your head. It's just like me. I'm saying that this friend, my mom used to say, don't deal with your friend. Don't deal with my friend. And I knew my mom was kind of right, but I always try to go along with it. Then, you know, eventually you fucking find out that friend. Or my wife will tell me, hey, Don't fuck with that friend. Don't fuck with that friend. You know, kind of back of your head, that friend is a piece of shit. Yeah. You know, then you fucking...
What do you think about the fact that the United States is one of the five countries that still makes foreigners have a vaccine card to get in?
I haven't thought much about it.
I have a lot of family in Africa, in Nigeria. They didn't need to be vaccinated. So, like, it depends on everybody's context, right?
It's funny that in Haiti, the death rate is so low, but nobody even had access to vaccines.
I didn't know that. My uncle told me, he was like, hey, the people that were inside of Nigeria, they got COVID. The ones that were outside, it's 90-some-odd degrees there. You can't really catch a virus when it's...
Sweat that shit out.
Just sweat it out, man. Yeah.
Should we mandate vaccines? Should everybody get the vaccine?
I don't think mandating is the thing. I think...
They did in New York City.
They didn't in Cuba, and the vast majority.
We're here. We're in New York, yeah.
Right, but that's the difference in the system. Here, it's forcing something on people rather than respectfully educating and involving them in making an important decision. No, mandates are just another punishment, the same as, you know, outlawing a lot of things that are people's personal interest.
Did you get it out of fear? Or like, what was your reasoning for getting it so early?
Honestly, man, I wasn't really thinking deeply about it. Probably a little bit of mob mentality, right? Necessity to be able to travel. I was traveling a lot at the time.
Do you regret taking it?
I don't necessarily regret it. Like I said,
why don't you get the booster? Why don't you get the other half?
Just logistics. Just never got around to it. But I will.
Okay. Yeah. They're giving out $100 and a burger right now if you go get it in New York.
Where's that? All over the place.
Yeah. You $100 and a burger.
Trust those little booths, man. I'm going to get anything from those little booths.
The little booths outside?
Yeah.
No, those people don't want to be there.
This is low key a little booth outside.
This is more professional than the COVID vaccine booths. I would trust this more than those random. Okay, like.
Yeah, I won't show up to a booth.
You have kids?
Yes.
Would you vaccinate your kids?
Of course.
Well, and especially having a kid. That's the whole thing too. If you have a kid, you're pretty much stuck. You know, then they got you, you know, because you can't really wild out or act up if you have a kid. You know what I'm saying? You want to try to do the best for them. So that's the...
Do you think having a kid is part of the governmental control?
Of course, because, you know, you can't move around. You got to go to work, so you got to take care of your kid, man. You know, if they tell you that, hey, you got to take this vaccine, well, you know, you're going to have a fucking problem. And your kid got to eat, bro. That's like, I will cry. I'll be like, yo, dude, of course, let me get all the vaccine I can fucking get. I got to... You know, that's the sad part about it, you know? That's the sad part. That's why I'm lucky I have no kids, you know?
What do you think about this? This is Michael Phelps' ad on Instagram. It says, I've been working on something that I could finally share with you. It wasn't until recently that I learned my struggle with depression puts me at high risk for severe COVID. Taking care of my health is important, makes me a better husband, son, and father. That's why I'm partnering with Pfizer to encourage people to know what risk factors could put them at a high risk for getting very sick from COVID. Know your risk. And then here they put a link to Pfizer. So basically they want us to keep taking it. It's not going to stop. There's going to be five, six.
I don't know. I mean, it's Michael Phelps being paid to say nice things about Pfizer.
I totally.
It's Fashion Nova, but celebrities are taking Pfizer ads.
Of course, but Pfizer, guess what? Pfizer, biggest vaccine company ever. Michael Phelps is legend. So it's good for him to spread that type of energy, you know?
He also sells Xanax and boner pills.
Pfizer?
Yeah. Pfizer makes Xanax and Pfizer makes Viagra.
Oh, shit. Yeah,
it's the same company telling you about your health is selling stuff that makes you... It's bad for your health, Xanax, and makes your dick, like, makes your heart beat fast to make your dick hard.
You know what? The thing about COVID is that we really don't have enough information. We're all kind of depending on what the government is telling us what the vaccination companies are telling us.
What about celebrities? Do you trust Michael Phelps? Michael Phelps is saying he knows more.
He doesn't have his personal opinion, you know? And it's
not his personal opinion. It's sponsored by Pfizer.
Well, then if it's sponsored by Pfizer, they have their vested interests in it. You know, you can't always trust the people who are promoting something because at the end of the day, they're all running a business.
What do you think about the anti-vaxxers, the conspiracy theorists?
I think I just explained that.
They're causing doubt.
It's fear, fear-mongering, doubt spreading. And I think it has, you know, it has potential serious risks.
Couldn't you equally say that the commercial I showed you, stuff like that, is also fear-mongering, saying that my depression puts me at risk, saying that you need to stay 6 feet away? Isn't there an element of fear-mongering in order to push the vaccine?
No, sure. Sure, there is. But there's no doubt we had a serious disease to tackle.
Do you think it's ever going to end?
Which?
The COVID. Do you think that disease... The fear-mongering or the COVID? I think the fear-mongering is worse.
I don't know. It depends on what kind of virus we're dealing with. We have a lot of diseases that we've known about for 50 years, and we vaccinate our children still today, right? That is how we keep the disease at bay. So that just because it's ongoing doesn't mean it's a hoax, but just because it's ongoing also, like, it, you don't, we don't know for sure, but we know that there are diseases that my children would have likely died from if they were born 50, 60 years ago, and because of vaccines, I don't have to worry about that.
Do you think that they took money to go and push the vaccine? Big media, big pharma, you think that they all made money off of this?
I mean, certainly people made money off the vaccine. I mean, I don't, like, oppose that. Like, you gotta make money somehow, right? But I mean...
Is that the right way to do it?
I don't know. I mean, like, personally, I mean, I support the vaccine, you know? I think, like, it's a good thing to get your vaccine.
What? You know, really?
I mean, like, you know, like, it's good to, like, get vaccinated. I mean, that doesn't mean, like, you know, like, if some people don't want to take it, they should have the right to not want to take it. Like, it's their choice, you know?
Based on how you took it, it doesn't really seem like you had a choice. You labeled the conspiracy theorists that they're fear-mongering for asking questions and having doubt. Isn't one of the definitions of science questioning science?
Yeah, it's asking questions, for sure.
The conspiracy theorists are labeled as fear-mongers, even though they're...
Conspiracy theorists. I just said that there's a lot of people who... It seems like the only purpose is to spread fear and doubt. That is not what science does. Science asks questions to get better answers. And I don't see... There's a lot of searching for better answers in just fear-mongering.
I mean... At that moment, like, you had to take it if you wanted to go to school, so...
It's not really much of a choice.
I mean...
School, I would say, is a necessity for a lot of people.
Yeah, I mean, definitely for me, too, right? Like, with everything that I do, you know?
You believe in a woman's right to choose what she wants to do with her body, your body, your choice?
Oh, absolutely.
Why does that not apply to vaccines?
I mean... I don't know. I feel like it's different when we're talking about, like, abortion for, like, a woman... or a woman's right to choose whether she wants to have a baby or not versus a vaccine. I feel like, you know, that's more threatening to a woman's life than, like, a vaccine. I just feel like abortion is, like, more threatening to a woman's life than just, like, having to take a vaccine.
Can killing a baby is more important than the flu?
I wouldn't say it's killing a baby. I mean, you know, I
killing a fetus?
Yeah, killing a, I mean,
so you'd rather kill a fetus than get the flu?
I mean, okay, that's quite a way to like frame it, SNEAKO, but I mean, I don't know, like, no, I choose not to answer that, obviously.